this is where the series starts to fall apart for me. X-Men 3, also known as Last Stand, released in 2006, directed by Brett Ratner. Starring all the usual suspects, but along with Kelsey Grammer, Vinnie Jones, Elliot Page. Oh, and that's about, I thought it was another one, but no, there isn't. Okay. And Elliot Page. Production budget of $210 million, a worldwide taking of $460 million, for a total profit of $250 million, less all marketing and associated costs. Okay, so X3, The Last Stand. I don't know. I really quite enjoyed this movie, but at the same time, I kind of didn't.
It was a weird movie experience. I spent most of this film trying to figure out why I wasn't having as much fun as I thought I should be having. It was odd.
It's felt like a lot of opportunity lost in this film, actually. A little dirty that Scott gets snuffed out so early on. Scott Summers got the worst deal in this series. Wolverine becoming the great leader of men, kind of in this film as well. Not sure about that. I much prefer Storm as the leader of the X-Men. She is much more capable, charismatic, she's much more caring. Wolvie, I like Wolverine, but he's not a great leader. And while I love Hugh Jackman's performance usually, I'm not so certain about the direction they took him in this film. Good to see Kitty Pryde with a bigger role, great to have Colossus around more. Multiman and Juggernaut, I mean, come on, that was cool, right? Vinnie Jones with the Juggernaut, pretty much perfect casting. And then he kind of got sort of ignored. And it kind of felt like a wasted character, again. And there's a lot of that in here. I mean, apparently this is Psylocke. Kind of wasted. Oh, speaking of which, Mystique.
I've just noticed during editing that I say kinda a lot. It's a symptom of me not knowing what to say because I'm confused or conflicted. And everything just feels kind of like gray and mushy regarding the film itself. Anyhow, let's take that back.
Mystique. She was great in the first two. In this one, she turns up, does some cool stuff, and then is just dink, neutralized, and no longer relevant to the film. Aside from becoming an informant for the FBI, because Magneto just dropped her cold right there. I felt that was weird. Honestly, him just dumping Mystique like that just felt out of place. It didn't seem right. Other thing that didn't seem right was the treatment of the Phoenix Force in this.
Phoenix shouldn't be a subplot, okay?
Admittedly, to bring the Phoenix Force to the big screen, would take a lot more than what they did. The Phoenix is such a big event. And to just cold drop her into the third movie and expect it to have the resonance and the impact that people are wanting, undoubtedly, I think that's a bit much. You got the fairly unnecessary romantic subplot going on there. I mean, Rogue's whole sub-story didn't need much more motivation than she can't touch people, go get the cure, you know? Didn't need the romantic triangle, broken heart, sub-thingy. Kind of pointless. Kind of pointless describes, I'm going to go with about 50% of this film. So you feel bad about all these things I'm saying, because at the same time, I really enjoyed a lot of parts of this movie. Kelsey Grammer as Beast, pretty much perfect. Ian McKellen's performance as Magneto was fantastic. Really enjoyed his performance, apart from a couple of hiccups that I mentioned before. And every now and then, this really felt like X-Men. This was full on. This was great. It really felt like one of the cartoons, one of the comics. And then it didn't again shortly after, actually. And Wolverine killing Phoenix at the end to save humanity and the mutant race and blah, blah, blah. You know, okay, very dramatic, a little pointless, but dramatic nonetheless. Why didn't you just go and grab the little anti-mutant kid, the kid with the nullification field, and run at Phoenix with that? You know, just walk up and get the kid to give her a hug. Maybe the Phoenix would have been too powerful. But at the same time, she hadn't been too powerful yet until the very end. I don't know. Look, it feels like a good enough finale, but, you know, it's just lacking, I want to say substance, but that's not true. There's so much. Maybe it's just too much. Maybe there's so much clutter. Cluttered. There we go. The film felt cluttered to me, which is a weird thing to say because it's an X-Men movie. You want as many mutants as possible, but perhaps not this many mutants, or at least not so many popping up and going away that you can't keep track of them anymore. And again, with Psylocke, I mean, come on. That's it? That's it. Ugh. So anyway, what's the final score? I'll be putting this one one peg below standard. It's not terrible, and it's certainly not the worst. It's the start of the decline in the X-Men movie quality, as far as I'm concerned. But quick question for you. Do you think there were too many mutants in this movie? or just not enough story or time spent on them. Anyhow, thanks for watching. Hope you're having a great week and get some time to go and watch a movie.